It's Christmas time. I'm the Vintage Collector, and these are my short Advent time stories. It's crazy how far we have come. Back in the days when you bought some software, you basically received a floppy disk, or even before, some tape or even punch tapes which contained the software, and that was about it. Good luck in getting updates. Time were definitely more rough back then, but at least with the advent of bulletin board systems and eventually the internet, you could, to some extent, get hold of program updates already. I was myself a frequent guest on BBSs and FTP sites like ftpmicrosoft.com. But aside from how impractical it was, going to find everything yourself, getting updates directly through the internet was certainly the next logical step. But believe it or not, Windows learned this only when Windows 98 came along, bringing you Windows Update to inspect your system for any missing updates and installing them right away. Luckily, that was then even made available on Windows 95 and NT 4.0 at the concession of installing Internet Explorer 4.0. Now, these historic OS versions are long gone, and it's only logical Microsoft ceased support for those since many years. No way to update your legacy OS nowadays unless you have all those patch files offline. But thanks to some enthusiasts, there are two projects to bring back Windows Update.
Wait, two competing projects? What gives?
I wouldn't exactly call them competing, but supplementary, as legacyupdate.net, which I featured already in a video last year, targets at the more recent NT line of operating systems. Windows Update Restored, on the other side, targets at the older operating systems all the way back to Windows 95, though it also includes NT 4.0, Windows 2000 and Windows XP, so there's a small overlap with legacyupdate.net. As noted before, you need to have Internet Explorer 4.0, which is locally provided through WindowsUpdateRestore.com. As the documentation says, a German copy of Windows 95 should work. I was tempted to try it out. But see here, those 404 errors clearly indicate it's not working. So maybe the documentation was not fully up to date. Who knows? Hence I went forth to try it with an English copy of Windows 95, and this worked like a charm. It gave me a full bunch of missing patches and yet an even bigger list of missing add-ons and functionality updates. Of course, this won't give you any new security updates. It's a mere showcase to have it running again, so you can relive and experience it firsthand the way it was some 26 years ago. What do you think about it? Let me know in the comments below. I'm the Vintage Collector, and this was my short Advent Time story for today. Thanks for watching, and see you again tomorrow.